Good morning, children. Today we are going to start our new chapter, Buy Back Off. Very interesting chapter. And from this chapter, we will learn how to be the most courageous person, okay? And how to be fearless, any fear. In previous chapter, we have learned about the life of village, where how the village people, they are most rich and contributing their wealth to our country. So let's start our new chapter. You can see the conversation in between the hares. They have a meeting and they are talking about themselves. So let's see the first what he is saying. We have so many enemies. Why they are saying enemies? Because the men, dogs, birds and wild animals, they are attacking. For some of them are food, some of them just for the fun, okay? So they just wanted to be get rid of from this, so they are discussing what will be the solution. So here the others is saying, but we don't have the courage or strength to protect ourselves. So they are thinking themselves that they don't have courage or strength to face these animals, to fight with these animals. We are so weak and helpless. So they have the negative thinking that they are weak and helpless, but actually they are not. Among animals, hares are the most timid. That means the lack of courage. One day, the hares held a meeting to discuss their fears. That means everyone is talking that from what they are fear of. Okay, so one is saying, come, let's end our miserable life. So one of them is saying, just let's kill ourselves. So the other here is saying, yes, that is the only way out. So for him, that this is the only way where we can protect ourselves. Because the life they are living, they are thinking that is a very miserable life. Everyone is attacking us, killing us. Is it hurting them? So just they don't want to live this life. So here you see the blank. Hares are the timid animals. Then you see the next. The hares rushed together to drown themselves in a lake nearby. So everyone is going to drown themselves, kill themselves. Why? Because they felt weak and helpless. So here, when they were running, here the frogs, they were talking and they heard the sound that the hares are coming. So what they decided? To hide themselves in the deep inside the lake. Some frogs were sitting by the lakeside. They got scared when they heard the sound of hares running. They're scared, and where they went? They went in the deepest end of the lake. The frog leapt into deep end of lake and hid themselves. So everyone hid themselves. Friends, stop. Let's not lose heart and kill ourselves. So one of the hares told them to stop. Did you see how these creatures got scared of us? They said they noticed that some other creatures are also scaring from them. This means they are more timid than us. That means someone others are also there who are more timid than us. There is hope for us. Let's go back to our homes. So when they saw that the frogs are hiding themselves, the hope come inside them that might be we are strong. Then one of the elder hare was wiser than the other. He asked the hares to stay calm. So one of the elder hare said, just stay calm. Okay. The frogs were more dash than the hares. So what? The frogs were more scared than the hares. So in this way, the hares Here's notice that there are many creatures. Every creature has a fear of other animals that might be he will be eaten by them. So why to kill themselves? Is it either you protect yourself or you fight? Okay? So whatever problem comes in front of us, we should not go back. We should not run off from them. We should fight. We should face. Okay? Because this is not the only solution to run off from the problem. Clear? So now we'll be doing some exercises from this chapter. So from this chapter, we learned that runoff is not a solution. We should stand, fight against, and we have to be bold. Let's just see, think a little. The fear of failure can hold us back in life. Yes, we cannot proceed, we cannot succeed. Your palms may sweat when you have to perform on stage. In competition, you may look at others and feel scared. It's a natural human nature that if you are on the stage, you have sweats on your palm and you are afraid that you are not good enough to compete. When you face such situation, you usually feel like saying, I can't, I give up. Let me go back. Fear make you feel scared and timid. This fear, which is nothing, it make you timid. You lose confidence and stop looking ahead. And what you lose? Your confidence, which doesn't allow you to look ahead. Actually, in fear, people stop thinking. So what is the psychological reason here? That in fear, you stop thinking. Instead of saying, I'll face it, they want to run from there. So instead of facing, you want to run from there. Do you know? Others may also be feeling scared and timid. Okay? This is internally. We cannot see that someone is scared. So try to not give too much importance to your fears and doubt. So how to get rid of from these? So we should not give importance to our fears and doubts. Instead, face the situation confidently. So, in order to gain the confidence, we have to be bold. Discipline as yourself repeatedly to do the thing. You fear until the fear disappears. So, whatever thing, whatever work, whatever competition, when you fear, you should keep on doing. So, what will happen one day? Your fear will disappear. And trust that God is always with you. As your fear grows smaller, your confidence will grow. So this is a very good formula. That as your fear grows smaller, your confidence will grow. Soon your fears will lose their control over you. So one day, whatever fear is controlling over you, it will be what? Out from you. And you will be the winner. And one day, you will be the win. Okay, so today's class work, what you are going to do is draw a poster showing the following expression. So here you have to draw the poster of fear and joy after the fear has been overcome. Draw a poster and color it. Okay.